Welcome to another Let's Play conducted by me, Einkrow. And this one is dedicated to Joshua H. Grizzle. Now, I'm going to play Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition. The Prepare to Die Edition is another name for the Definitive Edition, which is another name for the only edition that anyone should ever be playing of Dark Souls, which is, of course, a way of saying, I'm playing this shit on PC. This is one of the worst PC ports I've ever played. It's absolutely freaking terrible. However, I am using a suite of fixes known as DS Fix, which makes the game run at 60 FPS and at 2560 by 1440. Now that brings up another issue. This Let's Play is probably going to be a bit odd in that I present it in not only 2560 pixels by 1440 pixels, also known as the wide quad HD resolution. It's known as quad HD because it is four times the resolution of simple HD, which is better known as 720p. I'm going to present it in that resolution and also, probably in a few parts or so, also in 3D. This game does work in 3D. It has been fixed by Helix with his own Helix mod system for 3D vision, the 3D vision stereoscopic drivers. But it takes some setting up to make all of that work, and I didn't really feel like doing that tonight. I just wanted to get into the game, start playing. So we're going to be going back and forth. It's weird, but that's what I'm doing. So I have played about an hour and 1 minute and 36 seconds as Kelso Finnegan, the very smiley black man that you see on screen here. And finally, there's some music. It's very strange. There's no music on the very title screen, but whatever. So I played a bit just to get my bearings. I did play Demon's Souls on the PlayStation 3, but I did not play Dark Souls on any console. So I just wanted to make sure that I get a sense of the controls before I start doing this here. I just played basically the tutorial section, and that was it. I'm going to be playing this with a controller because the mouse and keyboard controls are terrible. And I need to create a character here, so I'm thinking before I choose a name, I want to see what kind of character I'm actually going to create. I could do a male or a female. Abilities are not affected. Very fucking typical, isn't that, huh? There's no bonus to strength for being a male. There's no detriment to strength for being a female, or to dexterity, or other things that are affected by your sex in the real world. But that's just how RPGs do things. I think I prefer to play Wanderer, a dexterity character, rather than like a knight or a warrior, who are designed to basically absorb and mitigate damage. I guess I could also go with a thief, but not too keen on his starting weapon. Has the master key, I don't know. Demon's Souls and Dark Souls were very cryptic games, so just has Master Key. They don't tell you what the Master Key is or anything. I think I'll go Wanderer. Blessing, I went with... Or not Blessing, Gift. I went with the Black Firebomb in my test run-through, which basically gives you one Firebomb, which I accidentally pressed the X button and wasted. So think I won't go with that one. Opens any basic lock. Okay, so that's what the master key does. Basic locks. So there are locked chests in this game, which there weren't in Demon's Souls. Binoculars sounds pretty fucking useless. I guess you can get two humanities to start with. Or two humanity to start with, and I actually do not know what they do. But I think I'll just go with that. It seems like the gifts are less impactful than they were in Demon's Souls. So I think I'll go with just slim physique. Face, you don't get a whole lot of options here. It's basically a set of presets. All of them hideously fucking ugly, especially the jubilant Katarina. Let's look at that motherfucker. Look at that motherfucker. You want to choose a black guy. That's your only option. The Jubilant Katarina. And I do want to choose a black guy, so... Fuck! I gotta do it. I don't have a choice. Alright, let's see. You can go with the Vegeta hairstyle. Short. Swept back. Hideous. Ponytail. Hideous. Wild. Fucking hideous. Parted center. Doubly fucking hideous. I mean... I gotta accept that there's nothing but hideousness. Oh my god. Oh my god. No. That is the worst. Curly. Let's go with curly, because... I don't know. The curly hair is kind of an eccentric hairstyle. It kind of goes with his eccentric looks, his eccentric face and smile, and his very bright pinkish lips. Oh no, it gets even worse. Hair colors. Purple, red, oh my god. The red matches his cheeks quite nicely. But no, we're not doing that. Dark brown looks more yellow to me. He's a black guy, so we're just gonna go with black, alright? So this basically is the same character I created in terms of looks and class and sex and physique. Actually, what is the female one? Oh shit. Okay, that's fine. Maybe the jubilant Katarina looks... Oh my god! I was hoping against hope that she would look better. She doesn't. Maybe with a hairstyle she'll look okay. Let's see. No. Maybe... Wave. I wish you could spin the character models, but... Not possible here. Very short, no way. Oh god, no. That's inappropriate for a black woman. Bun. These are all kind of inappropriate, to be honest with you. Let's just go straight, eh? She can look like, fuck, what was her name? The prosecutor from Sons of Anarchy, Sims. Before she did it with the real flow. Before she took her wig off. It's kind of the hairstyle she had, so we're gonna go with that.
What happened to her hair?
Supposed to be doing it with the real flow.
I don't know what that means.
Let's change name to... Fuck it. Claudette's... Ah, you can't get the full Sims. Claudette Sim will do it for me then. Alright. Shit, this is hideous, but we're going with it. Enter, thank you. What is customize? Isn't that like what I just did? Oh! You can't change the face. Okay. I'll make a few modifications here. No. All right. Hormones, masculine. Oh my god, and it changes like the color too. Ugh, shit, this game is ugly. The characters are ugly, but like, why does it like feminine turns you into like a freaking ghost? What are they thinking? Alright, that's a fine balance. Features, weak or strong. Seriously. These characters, I think, look uglier than the ones in Demon Souls, which were really bad. These are even worse. So features, basically, is like the look on her face. You can go from weak, which is like a dead blank stare, to like a very expressive look. Too expressive, honestly. Get her looking something like that. Create similar face. See what this does. It's not really doing anything. Color. You can change the color of the hair. All right there. That's fine. Customize the face even further? Oh, okay. Well, this is a bit too much. I didn't know about these options, but I don't want to get too much into it. This will be fine. You don't see the character's face. too much. It is a third-person game. There are no cutscenes and things like that. Well, there are cutscenes, but you only see your character, so. Okay. Character creation. There you go. Now for the cutscene.
In the age of ancients, the world was unformed, shrouded by fog. A land of gray crags, arch trees, and everlasting dragons. But then there was fire. And with fire came disparity. Heat and cold, life and death, and of course, light and dark. Then from the dark, they came and found the souls of lords within the flame. Nito, the first of the dead. The Witch of Izalith and her Daughters of Chaos. Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight, and his faithful knights. And the furtive pygmy, so easily forgotten. With the strength of lords, they challenged the dragons. Gwyn's mighty gods peeled apart their stone skins. Witches weaved great firestorms. Nito unleashed a miasma of death and disease. And Seath, the scales, betrayed his own, and the dragons were no more. Soon the flames will fade, and only dark will remain. Even now, there are only embers, and man sees not light, but only endless nights. And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side.
All right, hideous pre-rendered cutscene complete. All right, we are now into the game.
Yes, indeed. The dark sign brands the undead. And in this land, the undead are corralled and led to the north. Where they are locked away to await the end.
rise. Northern Undead Asylum.
Alright, so the first thing I need to do is actually restart the game. As I've said, this is a terrible frickin' console port, and unfortunately, this happened the first time too when I came through here, when I started up the game. The fix that makes it 60 FPS is not actually functioning right after the introductory cutscene, so I need to restart the game, and I should load back in right here. So, be right back. Okay, I'm back. It's running at 60 frames per second. Very lovely. Time to begin my journey as Claudette Sim. So, we're in a very nasty looking dungeon. Camera controls. Very obvious. Attack. Very obvious. Let's see if backstab is enabled yet. No. Oh, yep, there we go. Just needed to get him at the right angle. So, some interesting things to point out about this experience you are currently viewing. First of all, I am as usual... Ooh, there's the first boss. As usual, I am using sweet effects to enhance the visuals. There's it off, there's it on. As always, pretty subtle. But with this game, the game looks pretty... Let's just say, nasty. I mean, it's supposed to look nasty, but it looks nasty for the wrong reasons. This is... Of course, a console port. Texture resolution is not incredible. However, I'm using a texture mod to increase the resolution of the textures here, which is extremely important when I'm playing at a resolution such as 2560 by 1440 pixels, which the game was not designed to be played at. But with the high quality textures, it actually looks pretty nice. There are some good effects in the game, such as the glistening of the walls right there. Very nice. You get some a nice feeling of detail on the walls just because of the way the light hits it. Big fan of that. Let's climb up here. So what I'm doing with sweet effects is vibrance as usual. Pretty low settings for vibrance. Curves. Pretty low settings for curves as well, because it is already a very dark game. Don't want to darken it up too much more, but I do want to add some contrast. Rest at bonfire, increase HP, okay. So we'll get the first bonfire here. But I'm also using a feature that I sometimes use in games that are really bland looking, which is the DPX Cineon effect that you can enable in Sweet Effects, which adds quite a lot more color and punch to the image. So that's why the colors here are a lot stronger. It's hard to really tell in this area, but there will be areas where I'll turn it off and on again, and you can really see the difference. Let's turn it off and on right there. Pretty subtle, but I prefer seeing some color in this game. Okay, so the first boss is gonna drop down here. Get away! I imagine there's a nice achievement for killing the boss immediately with your starting weapon that literally does 2 damage every attack. I imagine there's a nice achievement similar to the way there was an achievement in the first Demon's Souls for killing the first boss, even though you were intended to die to the first boss. And in fact, if you killed the first boss in Demon's Souls, they actually designed the game to work if you managed to do that. It's not like you broke the game or anything. Oh, whoa, nearly dodged that. What would happen is that you would instead be sent to the mine level, the mine level final area, the boss of the mine level, which is World 2, if I recall. I forget the name of the actual level. Let's get this shield equipped. Okay. And then the dragon boss would kill you. Very nice, very easy. And then you start the game as usual. Alright, so I can probably dodge the arrows. Arrows are ridiculously slow in this game. But I do want to catch this guy before he runs around the corner. Have at ya. That didn't actually kill him. Because this weapon sucks. Ooh. That's the sword. I'm gonna kill him with this rusty sword hilt just because I can. Can I prevent him from ever firing an arrow? Oh, nice shot, dude. Nice shot. Let's dual wield this hilt. Let him fire first. Oh, shit. Alright, let's just lock on. Might make it easier. Nope. This is stupid, but entertaining to me. So, we're doing it. Hooah, hiyah, hiyah, hooah. Three strikes, total of 6 damage. My heavy attack only does 3 damage, so it's more efficient to do 3 light attacks. Pull back. Let him fire. Let my stamina recharge. One more round should do it. Actually, I think I might need another. Let's try and sneak in a couple more hits. Come on. Here we go. Impractical, but just imagine trying to beat the boss, which has probably like 800, 900 health just by using your sword hilt. Change equipment. Alrighty. So I've got twin humanities, which I do not want to accidentally use, so I'm gonna remove that. Unequip that. I guess it's just the equivalent of 2 humanities. Seems to make sense to me. Okay, so there is... Backstep, yep, I know about that. There is an item up here that I did not figure out how to get in my first playthrough of this tutorial. And I know that there is a locked gate up there, but I do not know where the key is. And I'm pretty sure you can't actually get up here like this. There's no jump button. I mean, there is a jump. There's like a leap, but it doesn't jump in the way you'd expect. So this isn't gonna work. Nah. I'm just gonna have to pay more attention when I go through this area this time. Okay, so there is a trap over here, similar to a trap in the first level of the first world, I should say. The first world of Demon's Souls, there's a rock trap. That rock trap right there got me the first time I came through here. Fortunately, I played this so I don't have to suffer the embarrassment.
You're no hollow. Thank goodness. I'm done for, I'm afraid. I'll die soon, then lose my sanity. I wish to ask something of you. You and I, we're both undead. Hear me out, will you? Regrettably, I have failed.
He can give me the key if I listen to him.
Perhaps you can keep the torch lit. There is an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead art chosen. In thine exodus from the undead asylum, maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient lords. When thou ringeth the bell of awakening, the fate of the undead thou shalt know. Well, now you know. And I can die with hope in my heart. Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. An Estus flask.
Oh, it's the flask, not the key. Sorry.
Oh, and this.
Oh, yeah, you...
Now I must
sorry,
bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now, and thank you.
Yes, he did give me a key. I'm sorry. I'm talking out my ass here. So, the first time I did kill this guy, because he said he'd be turning undead, and I thought maybe he'd enjoy the opportunity to be spared that fate, but he actually complains in a very, very sad manner.
Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now.
He's like, why should you do it? It's very sad. So I won't kill him this time. Now, I'm a wanderer, so I'm going to be more focused on avoiding damage than blocking damage. But in tight corridors like this, it can be difficult to kind of swing around. All right. So, there we go. Shortcut opened. Don't want to use that because it respawns enemies. So there was... I remember when people first learned about the Estus Flask. A replenishable base... It's basically a replenishable supply of moon grasses. And people thought it would make it too easy if you could just replenish your ability to restore health repeatedly. But the fact that enemies all respawn in the entire level when you replenish your Estus Flask is a very good way of balancing it. But we'll see as time goes on how well it really works. So, when you're playing Demon Souls, or Demon Souls or Dark Souls... Okay, that guy ran around unexpectedly. You want to be able to attack enemies without locking on, because this is a bad place to fight with a scimitar, because the lock-on system is kind of a crutch that you should not be using too much. These guys are kind of tough to take on two at a time. Fortunately, they don't have much health. Ooh, no! It's a very precise combat system, so every strike needs to count. There we go. I hope the clicks and clacks aren't being picked up too much. Move my controller away. This run looks very hokey. Yeah, that guy is over there. Hoo-ah! There's another enemy in here. Just get my shield out because I don't remember exactly where he is. Okay. Hoo-ah! This guy's got a bit of armor on him. And you think he does a three-strike attack? Right there, he only did two. Okay. There's his three-strike attack. Two. One. He's doing a heavy strike. Whoa. That was weird. Oh, he drinks. Reminds me of the Blue Eye and Red Eye Knights from Demon Souls. They would chug down some grass, moon grass. All right, jerk. I guess it's in some cases easier to just block damage, because then you can respond to what they're doing pretty easily. So yeah, that's locked. Do not know where the key is to it. It's not the same key that is on the boss. There's someone else who's playing. So the first time I did this, I failed to get the strike here. Oh, come on. Failed again. Move away when he does that. This guy's very similar in his attack patterns to the first boss of... Ooh! Forgot about that hit. He's very similar to the first boss of Demon Souls. Don't want to be too close to either of his sides when he's doing that attack that hits like that. Oh, I can't see. This is bad. Let me move. I'm not sure what's with the two bars on the bottom there. I think that might be a glitch. caused an interface glitch caused by something I'm doing with DS effect or fix. Yeah, I'm almost certain that's what it is. Ouch. Didn't have much room to move there. Surprised he missed. Oh, he's doing a big strike. Okay. Big pilgrim's key. Yeah, the interface is all screwed up. I'm using the interface fix that makes it a lot smaller because the size of the interface is obviously designed for televisions rather than for people sitting right in front of their monitors. So it's ginormous. This works pretty well, this size here. I've already broken all these pots in the past, and there's no other key that you can access. So, I guess I'll just have a quick look around. I mean, there's not gonna be anything here. That's where I climbed up from. Here's the shortcut. See any change with this guy? He disappeared. That's interesting. I would love to see what this item is. Maybe it's just a soul. But I cannot access it. I do not have the key. Which I... It makes sense that the layout would allow you to get through here if you got the key. Maybe you need the master key. And since I don't have the master key, I can't access it. Only certain characters do. That could be the case. And I don't really want to go this way because I'll take damage on the fall. So let's just do it like this. Yeah, that's what I'm going to go with. I don't believe that I'm being an idiot and missing something obvious. I believe that it's just simply that you need the master key, which I don't have. I like the way his or her hands don't actually touch the sides of the door. Oh well. Good job. Go straight ahead. There's nothing around here, so I will just go straight ahead. Okay. Managed to do this without dying. I almost feel like I'm a decent Demon Souls player. I keep saying Demon Souls, Dark Souls. That's a bit weird. That's a bit of weirdness, but it's okay. I'd rather have these black boxes than have a gigantic interface that takes up too much of the screen all the time. Intermittent issues are preferable to perpetual issues. That's how I think of it. All right, here we are in the first area. And with that, I'm going to conclude part one of this Let's Play of Dark Souls. Dark Souls 2 is coming out in about a month. I don't know. This is kind of screwed up. This is actually very screwed up. In fact, the interface is completely broken. All right, there we go. All right, so yeah. Dark Souls 2 is coming out in about a month on PC. But, of course, I'm way behind. I gotta take on the challenge of Dark Souls 1. So then, thanks for watching part 1. I'll probably start dying a lot in part 2. You wouldn't want to miss that.